Hi everyone, I hope you can hear me. My name is Divya Mahajan. I am the part of product team at Digital Vidya. I would like to welcome you all to the session on social selling for our community today. We have Gaurav and Apoorv for leading the session. Apoorv isn't here yet. Gaurav, can you please let me know by when he can join in?
I'm actually here. Hi, how are you?
I'm good. Achha, so you both have joined in from the same tool.
Absolutely.
Oh, great. So everyone, I would like to introduce you to Apoorv. He is the Vice President and Head of Global Brand, Digital Content Marketing and Marketing Communications for HTL Technologies. In his 11 years at HCL, he has performed various roles from driving business development to leading marketing strategy for enterprise application business. He is also a regular speaker at conferences like IAMAI, Marcon, Oracle Cloud World, LinkedIn Tech Connect, Microsoft Ignite, Hindustan Time Top 50 Brands, etc. He is also a columnist for Pitch and Digital Market Asia magazines. His upcoming book, You Are Key, Unlocking Doors Through Social Selling, hit number 23 in Amazon India's best-selling list, which is within 10 days of being launched in January 2016. And along with Apoorv, we have Gaurav. He is the co-writer at the book, and he also heads the digital marketing team at HCL Technologies. And Gaurav is responsible for online demand generation, digital platform management of HCL Technologies, conceptualizing, executing the global brand awareness campaigns, and aligning digital closely with business. Under his leadership and distinctive ability, the digital marketing team at HCL won more than 70 awards and is considered as vital contribution for HCL Technologies. And with this, I would like to welcome you both, and would like to hand over the session to you. And if just laying down the ground rules for everyone who has joined in the session for the first time, you can ask all your questions in the question panel on the right hand side. We'll take up all your questions, and we'll ask Gaurav and Apoorv after the session, after around 30 to 45 minutes. Great. Over to you, Apoorv and Gaurav.
Welcome everyone. Can everybody see the slides clearly? If I don't hear any comments, I'm assuming that you can see the slides clearly.
Yes, I can.
So my name is Apoorv. I have with my colleague Gaurav. On the slide which is being displayed right now, you can see our Twitter handles. Feel free to share questions on Twitter if you can't on the call. And in case there are questions we can't take up in this 1 hour, we'll be happy to get back to you on Twitter. Gaurav?
Thanks, Divya and Apoorv. So my name is Gaurav, and I head the digital marketing of HCL Technologies. Primarily, I'm right now looking into the business side of digital marketing, and glad to have a conversation with you on social selling. So I'm requesting Apoorv to begin the discussion.
Thank you, Gaurav. So let's start with what is changing in the world of selling. Divya, there is this sound on audio. Okay, it's gone. Thank you. So let's start by talking about what has changed in the world of selling. Selling in the digital era is very, very different from selling as practiced by companies earlier. There are a couple of key points to be noted here. Firstly, the way you should look at digital marketing, especially when working with sales, is not digital marketing, but marketing in a digital world. Now let's talk about the three large changes which the world is seeing in sales. Earlier, when you spoke to people and you spoke about when you're targeting prospects, how many prospects do you need to target to get a buying decision? People often said there are two or three people involved in a large decision. That's actually changed to six people. And in fact, some latest studies which are coming in now say that for any decision which is upwards of $5-10 million, there are often 8 to 9 people involved in making a decision. These teams are often cross-functional. So if you're an agency selling to a chief marketing officer kind of an audience, it doesn't mean that it's only the CMO involved. You could have the CIO involved because there's a lot of marketing which is tech. You could have procurement involved. And in all the three organizations, you will have many people involved. Now, the second thing is, which has changed is, social media earlier was all about brand salience. It has now moved to actually being a very strong enabler for lead generation. So the myth was social is good for salience, doesn't help in leads. It has changed to social can generate many leads. And B2B buyers are using social media more and more to be informed on vendors. It could be agencies, it could be IT outsourcing firms like us, it could be marketing consulting organizations. The era of cold calling is more or less dead. So the new prospecting is listening. If you're not listening to your prospects on social, your prospecting really won't be very, very successful. We are on slide 4 now. Now, what is very, very interesting is social selling is a huge, huge phenomena which is coming. So social sellers actually saw on an average a 16% great gain in YOY revenue. LinkedIn study says that they are 2x more likely to get promoted than their other peers who are not social sellers. And there is almost a 50% probability of them being more likely to achieve their sales quota. Now, these are amazing facts which show how important is social selling and why should we try to understand and leverage it for our companies. The first case study which we will share is HCL. We will share two case studies and then we will get inside what is the social selling framework. So both me and Gaurav work with HCL. HCL is a $7 billion company. We operate in 32 countries and we are predominantly a B2B organization selling into Fortune 500 and Global 2000 companies. The kind of services we sell are IT infrastructure management, BPO, application services and support, engineering and R&D services. So when we started the social selling journey with HCL, we first started very small with a sales team in Australia, New Zealand, and South Africa. Once we finished training them, in the 40-day period which preceded the training, after the training actually, the salespeople from these three countries added $350 million of revenue, which was almost double their funnel which they had before they got trained. When we did a one-year analysis after the training, we figured out that the salespeople who are actually on, who actually got trained, they almost had 105% more booking than the salespeople who were not trained. The bid to win, which is basically a parameter we use in B2B, which is nothing but how many proposals have you responded to and how many have you won. And you actually use the total commercial value to calculate this and not number of proposals, increased by 20%, and finally time taken to close an opportunity reduced by 26 days. So these are significant wins for any organization. We'll quickly talk about one more case study before we deep dive into what is social selling and why is it important. Now, IBM had a huge social selling program, and the way IBM started their social selling program is cloud computing was a huge market which was coming up, and IBM trained to start with 7 social selling followers, and the predominant tool which they used was LinkedIn Sales Navigator. Now, IBM social sellers actually had increase in LinkedIn followers from 535. So these 7 social sellers between them had 535 followers to 3,500. Their content reach increased to 1.3 million. And finally, their quota achievement went up significantly. There are many other organizations, including Oracle, Wipro, which are now training people on social selling. If all of you can be on slide 7 now, we've implemented a 6-stage social selling framework. Our book, You Are the Key, which is available on Amazon, actually talks about it. Now, the 6 steps are firstly understanding social platforms and creating a social persona. Now, why is a social persona important? A social persona is very, very important because if you don't have a clearly articulated personality on social media, then people will really not know what to reach out to you for. Let's take the example of, say, myself or Gaurav. Now, if you follow me on Twitter and my handle is A1PURVA, Apurv, or you add me on LinkedIn or follow me on LinkedIn, you will notice that I share a lot of content on digital marketing and digital transformation as it applies to business. So it becomes very, very important to have a consistent persona between social media platforms. It also becomes critical to develop your own personality and tone of voice and keep that same consistent so that when people start reaching out to you on Twitter, on LinkedIn, they don't become confused that these are separate people. It should be very clear that it's the same person across these same platforms. So best practice is to also use the same picture across social platforms. The second part of this whole six-step process is creating, collating, and publishing content. Now, a lot of us actually struggle with creating original content, but I would say don't be disheartened because on social media, you can also bring tremendous value to people who follow you or your suspects and prospects you want to engage with by just curating high-quality content and sharing with people. The third step is identifying prospects, and we will show you how do you identify prospects. The fourth step is actually listening in very well to prospects. And you remember we spoke about listening. So one of the biggest changes which has happened in the selling world is if you go back 10 years, say ABC, always be from ABC, which was always be closing, it has become always be connecting prospects and suspects. The fifth step is actually how should you approach a prospect? What is the right way to do it? Now, a tip here is don't do on social media what you won't do in real life. Like you would not like ideally to be rude in real life to someone, or you would not want to be seen as a stalker. Those are exactly the same principles which apply on social media. And finally, engaging prospects and nurturing a relationship. Now, between these six steps, you will notice that we are not using the word selling at all, because the whole premise of social selling is inbound marketing, which basically means if you create a compelling persona and you start becoming well known for something, and then you start reaching out to prospects, conversing with them, forming a relationship, sales will happen automatically as a byproduct, and you will really not need to sell. With this, I would like to hand over to my colleague and co-author Gaurav to run you through these six steps in more details. Gaurav, over to you.
Thanks a lot, Apu. So before we move forward, I just want to have a quick check with Divya. So is the voice audible and the screens are clear?
Absolutely, it is. Yeah, it's fine. There's no lag.
Okay, great. Thank you. Okay. All right. So Apoor has given a very interesting and, you know, very interesting background about social selling, what social selling is, why is it important, and he has also spoken about two case studies. One is about IBM and HCL. So the only point I want to add over here is that social selling is not only applicable to B2B, but also B2C, because we always sell to people, so it's B2B, right? So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cover the how part of the social selling. So as Apoor mentioned, there are six stages of social selling. So what we'll do in next 15, 20 minutes, we'll go through and brief you about what you need to do to be a successful social seller. And in case you want to get into details, in case you think this is a relevant topic for you, we would really suggest you can go and, you know, have a look. You can buy our book and get more details about all the stages and be a successful social seller. So stage one, I guess I spoke with Divya and she told me that most of you are very, very active on social media channels. So the first step is about being present on social media channels. And it's not about just being present on social media channels, but also if you are searchable, if you are if you can be easily found on social channels. So I guess Apoor wants to add something.
Yeah,
so
I was just saying, you're saying, Gaurav, that the 84 people who are present are very active on social media. I'm not seeing any tweets or anything, so how do we know whether they are active?
Okay, let's prove Apoor wrong. Let's be very active audience and participants. So if in case you want to prove Apoor that you are very actively listening, please use hashtag #YouAreTheKey and we will see and tag Apoor. So his Twitter handle is A1PURVA. All right. So coming back to the first stage is about creating your presence on social media channels. And the most important thing which I consider in stage one is improving your searchability, which is the core thing when you are there on social media. So what does it mean? So I do a quick check whenever I take a session face-to-face. I ask participants how many of them are are there on Google top 10 search results. So most of them, I only see 10% of people whenever I have taken session, only 10% of them are searchable on Google. So that means they are not coming in, rest of them are not coming in Google top 10 results. So I think it's very, very important being a social marketer or being a social seller or whatever, it needs to be very important that if someone searches for your name, it should come in top 3 results. So how can you do that? So I'll make you walk through some of the steps which you can use in order to be searchable. So I'm moving to slide number 9. I know there is a lag, so I will take a pause. Okay, I hope now you can see the slide. So the first step to make you searchable is wherever you are present on social media, be it Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, please add your company name to your social profile. Now, how does it matter? It really matters because people might search for your name. So let's say your name is Parag Samarth and you are not coming in top 10. And in case I still want to search you and I know that Parag is working at HCL, I may add a keyword HCL Technologies or HCL while searching for Parag Samarth. Now, there are 95% chances, and this is a proven data, there are 95% chances that you will come in Google top 10 results or maybe in Google top 3 results. So that's why it's very, very important that you add company name to all the social media profiles where you have presence. And moving to step number 2, as Apoor mentioned, one of the things which everyone needs to take care of is having a consistent presence across platform, which means that you should use one common platform across all the social channels. It is even applicable to Facebook because, you know, people can easily make out in case you have one single photograph being used across all the channels. And once you have done that, moving to step number 3, so depending upon the profession, so like on slide number 11, you can see Puneet Mehrotra, he has added some of the keywords like infrastructure service division. So he has created a profile with his expertise, you know, what kind of services he provide. So whatever service you are into, so let's say you are into food blogging or you are into travel, whatever expertise you carry within the IT industry also, you should add relevant keywords into your LinkedIn title. So how does it help? LinkedIn gives weightage to the LinkedIn title while searching for the people. So in case someone is searching for expertise in a particular skill which you are carrying, it will really, really help. So you should definitely add your skills in the title. Moving to step number 4, it is very, very important in order to get authority on Google, you should be very, very active on social media. So Google considers social signals to rank not only individual but also certain topics. And if you are active on all the social media channels, it will really boost your ranking on Google. So apart from this, there are some other tips which are not there on the deck, but I will verbally tell it to you. So there is a platform called about.me. What it does, it creates a profile about yourself. So put relevant keywords in that profile and integrate all your social media channels to about.me. So it will really, really help you dominate in the Google search results. Okay, so we have covered stage 1. I'm moving to stage number 2, which is how to publish high quality content. As Apoor mentioned, you know, it's very difficult to come up with the original content. Yes, there are ways through which you can you can source the content from other areas and add your point of view and be successful in publishing the content. And some people think that it takes around 1 hour to publish high engaging content every day to be active on social media. I think this is wrong. What you can do, you can spend only 5 minutes during the weekend, and there are smart ways. I will tell you some of the tools which you can use, and within 5 minutes you are done. You are ready for the whole week. And I divide this into two parts. So first part is uploading a content for the whole week using different tools, which we will see, and then keeping part of part of social media activity for real time content. So it really really helps, because real time engagement is much more important than publishing the content during the start of the week. So let's look at the ways how to publish content. So if you're active on Twitter, so this slide would be very, very relevant for you, because this shows what a perfect tweet should look like. So it is mentioned, I won't go into details, but I will summarize it. So whenever you're tweeting, keep 20 characters blank within your tweet. The reason is that people might retweet to you and they may add their point of view. So 20 characters for that. And also, you should keep at least 10 characters for the link. And you, definitely you are aware of that. You need to use one or two relevant hashtags, not more than that. Okay, now once you have created your presence, in case you are working in an organization like HCL or any organization which has good social presence, you can leverage the content of your organization. So what you can do, you can visit the pages of your company or whatever organization you're working for, and put the, and leverage the same content which is there on the pages of the organization, and just retweet or share whatever you want to do. And there are ways to schedule this content. You need not post all the content in one go. So I'll tell you some of the tools in which you can use to schedule the content and distribute across the different days of the week. Now, once you are done with that step, there are different tools to hunt for relevant content. So there are three applications which are very, very useful. The first one is SmartBrief, which is very, very relevant for all of us. And you can try it after this webinar or later on. Second is LinkedIn Pulse, which I think most of you are aware about. And third one is Cloud. So Cloud not only give you Cloud score, but also it gives you the relevant content which you can publish based on your interest. So the best part of Cloud is that it captures your interest areas, and based on that, it will give you the curated content which is relevant for your profile. Okay, so now we are looking into the tool slide. So you can see three tools. My favorite one is Hootsuite. I'm sure most of you are aware about it, but those who are not aware about it, it's one of the free tools, so they follow freemium model. What it does, you can integrate all the social media channels, so be it LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, you can link all these channels to this particular tool, and you can create different content sources. So let's say you want to search for IoT or Internet of Things, or let's say you are searching for Google Wearable or Apple iPhone. Once you put this keyword over there, it will give you the relevant content around this topic. And what you can do, you can pick up the relevant content, and they have inbuilt engine wherein they provide scheduling of content. So what it does, you can select the relevant day, relevant time when you want to post the content, and that's it what you need to do. Select the channel, select the content, and select the relevant timing, and you are done. So it's one of the trick which can be used to minimize time on sourcing the content And also, you are done for the week. So this is one of the way you prepare yourself for the week to publish the content. And there are some interesting component of this tool. Let's say you are following a particular person. Let's say you are following Parag Samarth. And since Twitter is very noisy, so it's very difficult to get the relevant tweets from Parag Samarth. Twitter timeline would be flooded with all the tweets. Now, what you can do, you can use the tools like Hootsuite, wherein you can create a stream around a particular tweet, Twitter handle. So you can choose the Twitter handle of Parag Samarth and create a stream, and you will only see the Twitter tweets around Parag Samarth which are tweeted by him or someone is tweeting to him. So you can see, get a 360 degree view of this particular person. So that's one of the wonderful way to listen to what other prospects or other people whom you are following, and it gives you a good opportunity to engage with them whenever you get a particular trigger. So we will look into the different modes of this, how to publish content and how to listen to them one by one. All right, so I am at stage 3, which is about identifying prospect. So the assumption is by this time you have already created your presence, which is step number 1. I'm getting the pop-up again and again, Divya, so people are joining and I guess we are full. Can we do something?
Yeah.
Okay, so
we send out recording to them. You can disable
okay.
it.
Okay, so those who are okay, I think I got it and I'm not getting it now. Thank you. Okay, so I'm at stage 3. So by this stage, assumption is that you have already created your social presence and you are aware how to publish content and you have created a good profile and you know how to publish content on different channels. Now once you have done that, you are ready to identify your prospect. In fact, this step can go in parallel with creation of your social presence. So there is a tool called Riffle, you can see in the middle. RIFFLE. So what it does, in case you are looking the Twitter, in case you are looking for the LinkedIn profile or the Facebook profile or Google Plus profile of an individual, you just need to input the Twitter handle. So here is an example wherein I have put in the Twitter handle of Hug Hale, @HugHale, and once I do that, once I put in the Twitter handle, I get his Facebook profile, Google Plus profile and LinkedIn profile. So without searching, without putting in any effort, these tools give me the 360 degree presence, social presence of an individual. All right, so there are other tools like LinkedIn Sales Navigator, Riffle and Cloud, which can be used to identify the social presence of an individual. So in case you don't have LinkedIn Sales Navigator, which is a paid account, there are ways to search an individual by putting in the title, by putting in the function. So if we had some time, and I will definitely show it to you. All right, so we have covered 50% of the social selling journey, and now we are moving to the next stage, which is once you have identified your prospect, the next stage is about listening to them, what they are saying. And till now you would have observed we haven't approached to the prospect, we haven't tweeted to them or we haven't engaged with them, because it's very, very important that you understand what they are saying, what they are looking for, what is their interest area, then only you move to engagement and approaching them. So herein you can see two tweets which are giving a lot of insights. So the first tweet is, so since I am from IT industry, so I have taken the relevant examples. I hope you would be able to make out what it means. So he has tweeted that he has whisked, Jeff Cobb is the person whom we were listening, and he has tweeted that he visited SAP Salesforce last week. So that means Salesforce and SAP, what is common in between? Both of them are into CRM space. So that means Jeff Cobb, who's the CIO of a particular company, I won't name it, and he's one of our prospect, he's looking for evaluation of various CRM system, and HCL provides CRM implementation services. So that means it's very, very relevant for us to understand that there is a need of CRM within the organization where Jeff Cobb is working. And the next tweet is about his concern with SAP. So if you can read in between, he has mentioned tell SAP to Respeto their customers. So Respeto, he has mentioned what he meant was respect their customers. So he has used some other language over here. Now he has used mild dissatisfaction with SAP, which means there is an opportunity to, you know, understand what is the dissatisfaction, and if you can find out that information, maybe you can engage, maybe you can approach him, what kind of problem he is facing, and if you have that expertise, you can talk to him about that. Now, on slide number 22, what we have done, we have used various listening skills in order to come with the persona template of a buyer. So in this case, we have taken Jeff Cobb, and what we have done, we have divided his persona into various categories. What are his family details? What is personal info? Professional info, career info, past organization, and the conferences he has attended. So everything is captured, not even spending a single dollar. So everything is captured just by listening on different social media channels. So that's the power, friends, of social media channels. So once you accumulate this information, you will be at par, you know, with respect to your competitors. You will get an edge. All right. So in case any of you is interested in getting the persona template from us, just tweet to us and we will share this template with you in case you find it relevant. I hope most of you are active on LinkedIn. So there is a tool called Newsly. So what it does, in case you are connected with, let's say, 1,000 people, and 10 of them are your prospect who are very, very active on LinkedIn, or let's say on media, then what you can do, you can use this tool called Newsly. What it does, it will give you automated alerts whenever there is a conversation about your prospect in media. So whenever they get covered in media, they write an article in media, you will get an alert. So isn't it a wonderful way to engage with someone, because you get a trigger and you tell them fantastic article. So this is a tool which you can use. Now we are moving into the second last stage of the social selling, which is approaching prospect. So I'm not sure, when you connect with someone on LinkedIn, most of people, what they do, they use the default message and send a friend request or default request to the person whom they want to connect to. But believe you me, this doesn't work much. Most of the time, if the person is not aware about you, they may ignore your request. So the best way is come up with a personalized LinkedIn invitation request. So as you can see on this screen, what you need to do, you need to bring in the context that why do you need to connect with that person. And we have different templates, and in case someone is interested, we can definitely share it with you. Now on this slide, slide number 27, I would like to show what are the various components of perfect invitation message. So can you see that there are 7 components of perfect LinkedIn invitation, which includes having a good professional photograph, because your photograph is displayed once you send a request to someone. You need to have a personalized greeting. How you know them, this is very, very important. In case you have met them at a conference or a friend recommended you, you need to bring in the context, and definitely chances of accepting the request will increase, accepting the invitation would definitely increase. Why would you like to connect? This is very, very important. So you need to tell them what are the common areas, how you can help them, or how they are relevant for you, what you can learn from them. In case some of the people are very open in case, you know, they are thought leader and you tell them that we would like to learn and engage with you. So they will accept your request. You know, 5, 6, 7. All right, so we have covered all the, we are now at the last stage of social selling, which is about, once you have, the first step that we discussed was creating your presence, second was about publishing content, followed by listening, identifying prospect, then listening, and then how to approach to them. Once you have done all this, you are now all set to engage with them. Now, within this slide, you can see that again, that particular individual, Jeff Cobb, he, on the second tweet, he mentioned that, dear esteemed IT colleagues, anybody having experience with Apptio? If so, please let me know. Now, there can be two cases. Either, so if this prospect is in within your radar, there can be two scenarios. Either you know about Apptio or you don't know about Apptio. If you know about Apptio, well and good. This is the right moment. Make the move and tell him the relevant content. If you have published a blog, point him to the blog and ask him if he needs further information. Okay, so the second case is, even if you don't know about Apptio, what's the harm? Go and read about Apptio, ask your friend about Apptio, gather that information, make a blog entry, make a LinkedIn pulse entry, and share that piece of information with him. There is no harm. You want to engage with this prospect, try out that. It will definitely work. So again, the tools which you can use is Hootsuite tool, which allows you to identify, listen, engage, approach, everything in one tool. So do try it, and in case you find you want to, you get stuck anywhere, please let us know and we would be happy to help you. So we have covered all the stages of social selling, right from creating your presence to how to engage, and as a board, we'll talk about selling that we have done within this. Social selling, as we believe, is oxymoron, and it's all about connecting with people, you know, finding out the relevant audience and engaging with them. Your first funding, the people who are willing to support you if you provide relevant context to them, if you reach out to them using a structured approach like we discussed right now. In case you are, you might have heard, you know, a lot of you actors also use social media. So we have heard about YouTube stars, YouTube rock stars. So everyone is using social selling. Even banks are using social selling. Even retail customers are using social selling. So the whole world is using social selling to connect with relevant audience. So just before we close, would like to tell you something about book. So we got an opportunity to engage with the CEO of Yum Brand, and he was very kind to share some of the feedback, some of his you know, testimonial about the book, which you can see over here. And Professor Balachandran, he's the founder of Great Lakes. And he was very kind enough to say a few words about our book. And in case you would like to know more about book, so you can follow this particular link. So bit.ly.com, Amazon order now. And that's it. So over to you, Divya. We can take up questions.
Sure. Thank you so much, Gaurav. Everyone who is interested in taking up a digital marketing course, can just fill up this poll, and if you are having any questions, you can type in the question panel on the right hand side. We'll take up all your questions. One question is from Guinea, is from Pramod. He's asking, is your book available on Kindle store?
So yeah, so we rolled out our book last month, 3rd of Feb. And we have requested the publisher, so they have promised us that the book will be available on Kindle by next month. So it would be available on Kindle.
Okay, great. Thank you so much. So taking up the question, I will just start from the first question. It's from Lisa. She's asking if, since people are shifting from one company to another, there's a huge chance of data loss. And how can we stop this data loss when it comes to maintaining your database?
Okay, so I think I have to assume some of the things while answering this question because the whole situation is not clear. So my assumption is that you're asking about enterprise wherein, let's say, they have deployed a CRM system and there is a list of customers. So let's say a person moved from company X to company Y and take company data with him or her. So I think today everything is available online. So in case you give me a list of all the participants, I can find out their Gmail ID. So there are ways to do that. We had very limited time, so I couldn't cover that. But there are ways to get the Gmail IDs. Once I get Gmail IDs, I can find out your Twitter handles. So there are ways to do that also. And I won't follow anything unethical. So yes, they are concerned related to data privacy. But in case, you know, the people are very active on social media, so everything is open. So that are some of my thoughts around, you know, people's contacts database or prospect database.
Okay, thank you so much. Next question is from Sudhir. He's asking, when it comes to connecting with clients on social profiles, it should be a person's individual profile or should they prefer using the organization's profile?
Yes, if you remember, I told that it's about P2P, person to person. Mm-hmm. Companies don't buy from company.
Okay.
So it is very important that you give a human touch to your organization. In fact, that's what IBM did, and we are also doing. IBM did an interesting thing. So they, when they launched the social selling program, they created small YouTube videos of all the participants. And they have also, if you go to IBM site, you can search people by their name. So this is a wonderful thing which they have done. And let me give you one example. So I was interacting with one gentleman who was very scared of social media. He didn't create his LinkedIn profile. Now he outsourced his LinkedIn profile to a company who created a fake profile about him. Now what happened, the outsourcing company did a fantastic job in promoting his account in terms of the thought leadership articles and the relevant stuff which was published by that account. Now what happened, the account got very, very popular, and today it's so popular that the person who was so scared about digital or LinkedIn, he felt like losing an opportunity, and today he's starting from zero. So that's the loss, my friend.
And thank you so much. Next question, another question is from Lisa. She's asking how a person should handle negative comments or negative shares on his social media if it directly impacts his brand value of the firm he's working for.
I think whatever is applicable in personal life is absolutely applicable on social media also. So one thing which I've learned is present yourself the same way you're present, you're doing in your real life. So no need to live two lives, one for social media and one for personal. So one of the basic things, so let's say you have made a mistake on, or there is some problem or any comments about you. So let's say you have made a mistake in real life also, you apologize and you know you accept the mistake. So there is no harm. People are very forgiving, so you can definitely apologize in case there's a mistake. Yes, if there is a negative conversation for which you are not responsible, you need to find out some of the advocates who can talk to, who can engage with the people who are talking negative about you. So leverage your network. Instead of replying to that person, leverage your network, leverage your community to attack to the people who are talking negative about you. I think that would be much more impactful. And I think now we are advising a lot of brands how they should manage their crisis crisis department. We also get within HCL, we also get a lot of complaints, but we have set up a workflow. We have set up a crisis management team which listens 24/7 to various negative comments that we get, and there is a proper governance that we follow to address that.
Thank you so much. Next question is from Himanshu. He is asking, it's all about data and digital marketing, and how can we use the technologies related to big data, data science and predictive analytics for digital marketing intelligence? Can you help him with some real life examples that how this process actually works?
Great question. So it is beyond what we are discussing, social selling. So it's about how enterprises are adopting digital. So at HCL, we have come up with a new offering called Beyond Digital, which is all about, you know, big data and whatever technology he has mentioned. So I'm sure that most of the participants have different interest areas. So what I would suggest this particular gentleman, that go to a website and search for digitalization. It will have the relevant content which you are looking for.
Great. Thank you so much. Taking up next question, it's from Pawan. He's asking, any tips for successfully selling social media to B2B business or a distributor?
Okay, so definitely, you know, whatever we have discussed today, you definitely know should know about your audience. So in case your audience is agencies or whatever B2B, so there would be people who are active on digital. And what people are looking for these days is not what kind of creative you can prepare or what kind of how many impressions you can get. They are looking for ROI. So in case you can talk in their language, in case you can understand what are their KPIs, what makes them successful, so talk in their language and, you know, always go with a personalized pitch. Like, I'm part of digital business, so I'm leading the digital consulting of HCL. So one of the things that we do, we also work with Fortune 500 clients and we also serve the digital marketing services. What we do, we always contextualize our conversation. So let's say I have to approach to any company. I won't name the company, so let's say it's company X. What I will do a brief analysis about the company. There is a proper framework that we have, our team has prepared it, and it analyzing the various parameters related to digital, and I tell them where do you stand as of now and where we can take you with our services. So it is very, very personalized, it is very, very specific, it is very, very relevant. In fact, some of the analysis that we have shown, they echo to our analysis and you know, they agree to our submissions that yes, these are the problem and these are the opportunity area. So contextualize, so the basic principle is contextualize your conversation, find out the relevant content which would be applicable to this particular company.
Thank you so much. Taking up another question, it's from Jabal. He's asking, how did you go about mapping your content assets to different stages of buying cycle in a B2B or an IT market?
Very, very, very good question. So glad you have some of the B2B audience over here because it's my strength area. There are different stages of buying cycle. It all starts with the IDA model, awareness, interest, desire, and action. Yes, there are different topics, different content applicable during the buying cycle. So you need to capture the customer 360 degree view. You really need to, before pushing the content to them, you need to understand in which buying stage they are. If you go to a website, that's what we have done, hcltech.com. Based on the industry of the person, we have personalized the content. So let's say you are coming from retail industry, you will only see the retail industry specific content. If you are coming from aeronautical, you will only see the aeronautical content. So there are different technologies. So one of the technologies is demand-based, which people can use to personalize the content. And what it also does, so let's say they have visited the website for the first time and they are coming for the second time. That means they are aware about my company. Now, I don't show them the same white paper or case study which I had shown during the first stage. So what we do, we always change the case study or the banner or the content depending upon the visit of the customer. So it's very, very relevant. So to use different technologies to enable all this. So like we use demand base. So that's one of the way to manage the content for different buying cycle.
Thank you so much. Another question is about what are your tips for small companies who do not have much visibility on social media?
I guess it doesn't matter if you are small or big. Even the big companies, I have seen companies like GE or companies like any Fortune 500, they are also finding it challenging to prove their presence on social media. One thing you need to be one thing which you need to take into consideration is that there is so much of noise. So how to be relevant in social media? So it's all about your community. So what you can do, you can follow two or three things which can be useful for you. First thing is, what do you want to achieve? What is your vision? So based on that, create your community. Maybe like yesterday, what we did. So Prateek is you know, he has come up with Digital Defined, and he came up with the to us that I want to conduct a session on social selling. So and that way he approached us and he asked us that, you know, can you help us conduct a session? So it's about, you know, what kind of content you are publishing, what is your vision, and what kind of network you have. So leverage your network, publish the relevant content, engage with thought leaders, and that's the way you can build your presence on social.
Thank you so much. Taking up Ashutosh's question, he's asking, how do you figure out your prospect customers and what's the research work one should do before approaching him or her?
Okay, so this we have already talked about within the social selling deck that we have seen. Definitely you can't approach directly to the prospect. What you need to do, you need to do some homework before approaching the prospect. So you can, so there are ways to find out the social handles of a particular prospect. We have seen some of the ways. So identify the presence of prospect, identify what kind of topics he's looking into, he or she is looking into, and find out that information. Also look into the network of the person. So LinkedIn gives you how you're connected with that person, or Twitter gives you who are the followers whom he is following. So in case you know a common connection, talk to that person. If he can introduce, that's the best way, because reference works better than approaching you know, at your own. So that's one of the tip which we didn't cover in the webinar, so which is something extra you can do. Find out the relevant common connections whom you can leverage.
Thank you so much. I believe we are done with your questions. If you have any other question, you can just tweet to Gaurav or Apoor directly, or you can drop an email to us. We'll respond to you individually. Thank you so much, Gaurav. Thank you so much, Apoor, for taking your time out. We loved having you over here, and it was a great session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Divya. Thank you, everyone, for attending the webinar. Look forward to interact with you.